how do we go there?
Huh?
Oh, I know. A map. We need a map to find the candy store.
Map? How do we find a map?
I've seen Ada and Cody using maps on computers. That's it. We need
a computer. Where is the map?
Raymond.
We need to use a software program to see the maps.
Software program? What's that?
Orchestras have a lot of musicians, and they play together perfectly. But how do they do that? They follow the instructions of the conductor of the orchestra. Similarly, software gives instructions to different parts of a computer. Software controls almost everything in a computer, right from the system software that switches it on to the application software that plays music and much more. Different software programs are designed to perform specific tasks based on the user's needs. Let's look at some examples of software programs. A word processor is a software program that lets us create, edit, and format text documents. An internet browser is another great example of a software program. It lets us access the internet, communicate with people, and even download photos and videos. Even the video games we play on computers and chatting applications are examples of software programs. So, where are all these software programs kept in a computer? They're stored in the computer's memory or on storage devices. We can even find software in other gadgets, like an electronic thermometer that shows your temperature and a pedometer that counts the number of steps we take. Software is very important and can be found in almost all digital devices around us, and it makes our devices easier to use.
Ah! We use the map software to find directions to the candy store, right?
You got it!
Yes! We got the map!
And now, we know how to reach the candy store. Let's go!
Wow!
Raymond!
Webster and Raymond are looking at all the different software programs on their computer. Which software program do you use the most often on your computer?